Okay, hello and good morning. This is another edition of Quick Tips. My name is William Hollis. I'm an associate librarian here at Mandel Public Library. And once again, as I said, this is another edition of our Quick Tips series in which we go over different tools and resources that can help you personally and hopefully professionally as well. So we have been going over different tips, as I said, as you do your job search, as you look to advance professionally, you might be applying for jobs or whatever the case may be, whatever you may be doing. So today we are going to go over how to use Google Docs, actually. And we're going to go over the cover letter. We've covered resumes before, but there may be times where you look at your resume and normally you like to keep that to a page, no more than a page and a half in length. And you may think, well, there's so much more experience that I would like to share that I can't seem to fit into my resume. And no employer wants to look at a 5-page resume. So we're going to address how you get those qualities across or how you include your extra qualifications that don't fit onto your resume. So with that in mind, the solution to that issue is the cover letter. So we are going to, now this is assuming we're already in our Gmail account. So we've already logged in as our Mr. John Q. Smith 60. So that's our fictional person who is, we're using to demonstrate how to do this. We're going to go to Google Apps. This is if you're already in your Gmail account, your Gmail is open. So we click Google Apps, and then we scroll down to Google Docs, and we're going to click on Google Docs, and you will see a series of templates. As you can see here, it says start a new document. You can start a blank document. You have a letter, resume. We've already gone over resume. So now we are going to take a look at letter. So there's a few different templates, but we'll go ahead and click letter. This is if you needed a starting point so you don't have to begin from scratch. So we click letter. And now we are going to fill out the template, basically. And this is what's great about templates is that you may not know where to begin. And this gives you a starting point where you literally just fill in the blanks. So we're going to say John Q. Smith. Then we're going to put the address. Again, you'll be putting your own information. You won't put John Q. Smith, obviously. You would put your own name. Now we're going to include your address, which actually you really don't need to put your street address. You can if you want. That's certainly up to you. You can even just put your city and state if you're more comfortable with that, but that's up to you again. So we'll just go ahead and say 123 Main Street. So we'll say 123 Main Street. We'll go ahead and say West Palm Beach, because that's where the library is. We'll say West Palm Beach for the city. Capital F, capital L for the state. And then we'll put in the zip code. We'll say that you're local. And then for the phone number, we'll say, 561-456-7890. So again, you'll put your own phone number. What's most important, you don't have to put your address. You could just put the city and state, but you do definitely want to put down your phone number and email address. If you watched our previous Quick Tips video, you should have created an email address or a Gmail address, which are one and the same. You should have created an email address so that these employers can reach you or so that people can reach you. So we are going to put down our email address that we have created. So for us, it would be Mr. John Q. Smith 60 at gmail.com, because obviously when we communicate with this employer, we're going to want them to be able to reach us. So then we're going to put today's date. So they have different formats for the date. You can change it if you want to. It's certainly up to you. Actually, for myself personally, I would say that I would like to just say 08-26-2020. So now we are going to go ahead and list the name and title of the person we're trying to reach. So if we have a name for like the director of human resources or that supervisor at least, then that's great. And it really looks impressive if we look that up, if we do the research and we find the name of the either director of human resources or that hiring manager or whoever the point of contact is. If you don't know that person, because I know that would be the natural question where you say, well, I don't know who that person is. You can certainly put the following if you don't have a name. I would say hiring manager or hiring director. Either one is fine. And then human resources, because human resources is always going to be the department that handles, you know, interviews and new hires and things like that. So if all else fails, if you have a name, that's great. If not, just put a title and department. That's going to be hiring manager, human resources, and I'll actually put the library's address. Let's say you were applying to the library. Obviously, you would put down your own information. So 411 Clematis Street, West Palm Beach, Florida. We're going to take out this other information. 33401. And now, as you can see, here it is. It says, Dear Miss Reader, you can even say hiring department, hiring manager, if you don't have a specific name. So if you do have a name, it's going to be Dear Mr. or Miss Whoever. So we'll say Dear Hiring Manager, or you could say Dear Human Resources, up to you. Now, they have a bunch of mumbo jumbo here, but we can certainly get rid of that and then type whatever we want. And there are actually other templates on other platforms, even such as, you know, Microsoft Word or wherever it is, where they'll have even phrases built in where it might say that I found, you know, I'm writing in regards to this vacancy and so forth and so on. But we're just going to highlight this information so we can put our own. They have some gibberish in there. I don't know what that means, but we can take that out. And then we can type our message. So if I wanted to do a simple letter, I guess, or a simple cover letter, you might say, Dear Hiring Manager, my name is, in this instance, John Q. Smith. You're gonna obviously put your own name. My name is John Q. Smith, and I am contacting you in regards to the vacancy for whichever position you're going for, you know what I mean? To the vacancy for the position of, I don't know, we'll say librarian because it's a library, but again, for whichever position you're going for, librarian that is listed on your website, for example. You would then list your qualifications, anything that you couldn't fit on your resume or any qualities, anything like that. You know, let's see, what is this saying? Okay. Okay, perfect. So you're just going to continue to list that information basically. So we said the vacancy for the position of, in this case, librarian, whatever's listed on your website. And then you might say, I have 5 years of transferable, which, by the way, I want to point this out too. If you don't have direct experience, you would list your skills that are transferable. So maybe you haven't been a librarian or you haven't done the specific position that you're going for, but you're going to talk about how you have transferable skills, or maybe a past position or past experience that you have is something that would apply to the position that you're going for. So that's just something important to go over. So you might say, I have 5 years of similar experience in, I don't know, education, and the skills I have acquired in my current position or past position if you're not currently employed are, and you might say, and I believe the skills I have acquired, I believe that the skills I have acquired in my mission would be transferable to this role. So that's just a short version. Again, you can certainly add on whatever you would like to list, you know what I mean? And then you go from there. So after you have added in whatever it is you would like to say, you would then say, I can be reached via phone or email, and I look forward to scheduling an interview to discuss this position. Sincerely, and then you would, in our template, I'm gonna make that a little bit less space. Sincerely, John Q. Smith. And of course, if you did this correctly, you already have your you already have everything filled out as far as your contact information. So sincerely, John Q. Smith. Now we can go ahead and save this. So we would say file. You can also, you know, you can also share it, but we'll go ahead and make a copy of it also. So let's go ahead and click make a copy. So we make a copy and we're going to say cover letter. Now also, you're not going to necessarily use the same exact cover letter for different positions. So we'll say librarian cover letter, because if you go for a different position, you're going to need to switch up your cover letter, at least some things in there. So librarian cover letter, we're going to say okay. And then we've saved a copy of that. And then also, if we want to share it within Google Drive, if we want to share this, we're going to click share. We can click share, and then we're not actually going to do it right now, but you would just list, well, actually, I guess we can do it. I'll do it to my work email then. So I'm going to click my work email. You would share it, put the person's email who you want to share it with, and then I would click send. And that's not a Google account, but I'm going to share it anyway. So let's say you're having a conversation with a hiring manager, and you don't have a paper resume or a paper cover letter with you, you can share your documents right there. You can say, oh, okay, I can use my Google Drive. I can share this document with you, so you don't have to have it with you physically. And then you say share anyway. And then you have shared your document. So that has been a quick tip about how to use Google Docs to create and share a cover letter. I hope that that was beneficial. Please stay in tune with us. Please check out our website. We are currently offering virtual programs, so that is certainly something that I hope that you will utilize. Once again, I can't say it enough that we are here to support the community, even in the midst of this pandemic, and we will continue to provide virtual services and offer as much services as we, or as many services, I'm sorry, as possible, so that we can continue to support the community and be a resource. Thank you so much for watching and listening, and you take care and have a great day.